Willkommen, bienvenue, and welcome to Spa-Francorchamps. This circuit was built in 1921, and even though its length was halved in 1979, the Belgian Grand Prix is still one of the longest, fastest, and most magical races on the F1 calendar. Spa-Francorchamps is famous for its long straights and fast corners. Drag efficiency will make all the difference here as drivers zoom through the famous sequence of Eau Rouge leading up into Radion. But a twisty middle sector keeps things tricky down on the track. We're about halfway through the season now, and there's still plenty of time for everything to change. All eyes are on the teams and how they tackle the rest of the year. What will happen this weekend? Only time will tell. Welcome back as we continue our race weekend. Practice has finished and qualifying is hot on its heels. We've already seen a lot of excitement building since Formula One arrived in town, and today's qualifying is sure to be no exception. Success may stem from a well-prepared strategy or a driver capable of incredible audacity. Put it this way, there simply is no surefire recipe for victory. Let the competition commence.
Radio check. That's green now. Green now.
The time has come to fight it out. It's race day.
Seeing how they did in qualifying, Williams are going to be the team to watch here. They'll be starting strong at the top of the grid and will have many opportunities to steer the race in their favor. We saw a reasonable push from Mercedes in qualifying, and they'll have plenty of opportunities here to achieve a great result. We've been having sunny weather here today, but there are some clouds looming that might complicate things for teams further down the line.
Well, no one can ever predict what will happen at Spa-Francorchamps, but one thing's for sure, it's going to be eventful. Now, we should have good weather for the race, and that will be welcome news for the teams. Looking now at the Williams. Starting in third place, they're in a really good position for this race. And looking at the second Williams car. They're starting in the bottom half of the grid today, so there's a lot of cars between them and the podium. The teams are ready to go. You can hear the excitement in the crowd here at the Belgian Grand Prix. It's lights out, and away we go.
Good job.
Overtake from Williams. And a new position just gained by Williams.
Good job.
Boxing.
Box.
Okay, back in the box.
inside there. And there's an overtake from Williams.
Good job.
And a new position just gained by Williams.
What you're doing. Good job.
Okay, that's good. That's good.
Keep doing what you're doing. That's great job, great job.
overtake from Williams. A new position just gained by Williams.
Doing what you're doing.
We've just had a car run wide. There's been a crash. Sounds like a single car.
Box.
Looks like there's been a lockup. Did someone run wide there? Sounds like a spin. I think someone's run wide.
Three laps to go.
Yeah, okay.
Two laps to go. Yellowhead.
Okay.
probably the last lap coming up.
And it's a win today for Lance Stroll. Well done, Lance Stroll. Excellent results for the Canadian driver. Williams have got to be happy with their results here. This was good work.
That's right. They've made some fine strategic decisions here, and it's brilliant to see them pay off.
After an intense weekend, the team ends in first place in the constructor standings.
For the next round, Formula One won't be straying too far. We'll be heading to the dunes of Zandvoort and the lightning speed of the Dutch Grand Prix.